Hello, I am Ram Gopal from presentationprocess.com. In this edition of Editable PowerPoint Infographics series, you will learn how to create filled spheres chart in PowerPoint. Let us see how this chart looks. This is how the editable infographic looks. It looks like there is a transparent sphere, a glass sphere, in which some liquid is filled to a certain percentage, and this can be used to represent 50% occupancy or 50% completion of a project and things like that. So this is a very beautiful infographic which you can use in your business slides. Let us see how to create this stunning looking infographic from scratch by going to a new slide. The first thing we are going to do is to draw an oval shape, for which we go to Auto Shapes menu, and under Basic Shapes you are going to choose this one called as Oval Tool. Click on it. While holding the Shift button, draw the sphere. Now we don't want this fill to be fully opaque, so I am going to right click, go to Format Shape. I am going to increase the transparency level to some, say, 37 to say, let's say 40% is the transparency level we would like to maintain for this one. Let us leave the outline the way it is, and we have done the first step. Let us keep it somewhere in the middle. Yeah, we have done the first step. The next thing is to draw the percentage fill, for which let us go once again to Auto Shapes menu, and under Basic Shapes, when you look for this tool called as Chord Tool, you will find that this is a perfect tool to draw the fill shape. So we go to Chord. We will hold the Shift button once more and we will draw the shape. Now we need to match the diameter of this circle with the diameter of this shape as well. So let us see what the diameter of this shape is. So we go to Format tab in the Home tab, and if you see this particular group called Size Group, you will be able to find the height and weight of this circle. So it is 2.55. when we enter the same values for this, you would be able to match the diameter as well. So we are going to make this 2.55 for height and 2.55 for width as well. Now this matches this perfectly. That is wonderful. Now the chord diagram has fill somewhere in a slanted way. We don't want it that way, so we are going to move the yellow handle here. We're going to hold this and we are going to move it to the left, pretty much matching the midpoint on the left hand side, left edge. And we are going to move this yellow handle to match the point on the right hand side. So now we have got a half fill for the circle. This looks beautiful. Now we are going to add some gradient fill to this one. So while we keep this selected, we go to the fill option and we are going to choose gradient fill. That is one way, or I'll Control Z again. Let us go to Shape Fill. You can use gradient here, and maybe we can fill this one called as Linear Up. So we have done the filling portion as well. Now to make it look 3D, there are two things we are going to do. The first thing is we are going to draw an oval shape or elliptical shape here that looks like you are seeing the fill from the top angle. So let us go to Auto Shapes menu once again and click on the Oval tool, and we are going to draw the oval shape here. To make sure that the width is exactly the same as the diameter, we will go to Format and we see if it is 2.55. Yeah, it is perfectly done, 2.55. And now that it is 2.55, we are going to choose a darker variant of the color that we have chosen earlier. We chose blue, so we are going to choose dark blue for the fill. Now when you see, it looks like we are seeing the sphere filled and we are seeing it from the top view. Now to add a bit of gloss to this, which is the second thing that we are going to do to make it look 3D, we will once again go to Auto Shapes menu, pick up the oval tool, and while holding the shift button, we are going to draw a circle which is almost 60% or 50% the size of the original circle, and we are going to place it somewhere close to the top edge and somewhere in the center. Now we are going to remove the shape outline by going to shape outline and no outline, and we are going to choose gradient fill for this one. So go to fill and go to gradient fill. We don't want three stops, so whenever you choose any of this you would be able to find out, and make sure that you only have two stops. So I'm going to pull this out so I only have two stops, and also the direction, the type is linear and the direction is linear up, so this darker portion is here and the lighter portion is that side. So what we're going to do is we are going to choose for this one, which is the lighter portion, we are going to choose white color, and we are going to increase the transparency to say 30%. Now the other one we are going to choose the same color as the blue that we have used here, and we are going to make the transparency to 100%. Now you can see that it looks like the sphere is glossy. Now all that is left for us to do is to pick the shadow and pick this text which tells about the level of percentage fill. I'm just going to save time by picking them from the previous slide, and I'm going to just stick them here, and the shadow I'm going to send to back and keep it here. There is a separate tutorial that teaches you how to create artificial shadows to create diagrams like this one. So there we have created editable infographic called Filled Spheres Chart. If you are a busy business presenter who doesn't have the time to create such professional looking infographics for yourself, you can always take a look at off-the-shelf solutions like our PowerPoint CEO packs, and I'm going to show you some example templates taken from our PowerPoint CEO packs where we have got some of these editable infographics available. For example, this is the same chart at different fill levels like 10%, 25%, 50%, etc. You choose the level that reflects the information that you want to portray, and you can remove everything else. So to pick up a particular chart, all you need to do is to go there, copy, make a new slide and paste it, and you've got the chart ready. You don't have to go through all the process that we have undergone just now. Another example template is this one, which is about thermometers, and this again is totally editable, and we have got a range of these fill levels. Just to make sure that you spend your time wisely, instead of fiddling around with graphics, you can spend your time on creating content. So that is the whole idea of our CEO packs. Let me show you another example template, and here this is an animated version of a bar chart, once again totally editable. We have three categories and we have different percentages, 100, and you can see category 1, category 2 and category 3. The tubes come first and then the level of fill comes in here, and as we said earlier, everything is editable. Say you want to have the level, instead of 50%, you want to have it say to 20%, you can just pull it down and it goes to 20%, and you write it as say 20% and then drag it down here. And this time when we go and show this, you have the tubes coming in, but this time the fill level is going to be just 20% and this one is 80%. So that is as easy it is to edit our templates. For busy business presenters like you, we have PowerPoint CEO Packs, Volume 1 and 2. There are more than 1,600 fully editable charts and graphics for CEOs and busy business presenters like you. Just choose the template that matches your thought, replace the sample text with your own text, and your business slides get ready in no time. Creating professional business slides has never been this easy. The quality of the charts that you see in CEO Packs is miles above the quality of charts that you see in any other pack that you might see anywhere else. In fact, quite a few people get inspired by our charts, and they keep making their own version of the same charts that we created first. So when you get our CEO Packs, you are supporting original content as well. If you like the tutorial on creating filled spheres infographic, if you want to read more articles like the one to improve your presentation skills and PowerPoint skills, or if you want to watch more videos like the one that you've just seen, please visit us at presentationprocess.com. Thanks a lot for watching the video, and happy presenting.